Thank you to the both of you for joining us. Shawn, tell us about your involvement with Flow Water. Are you lending your celebrity to a brand, or are you an investor in the brand?
I'm just a water snob, and I love really good water. No, I mean, you know, to be honest, I haven't worked with a lot of brands in the past, actually, but this Flo and I have, I feel like we've just been friends for a long time. I think I was like 16 when, or 17 when we first kind of started talking, and we didn't start working together for another like 3 years publicly, or 4 years publicly. It was like a real kind of slow burn family friendship kind of situation. My dad went and saw where the water was made and kind of everything in Ontario. And it just became something that I felt very connected to on a very personal level. And then on top of that, all the perks about how it's just an absolutely incredible, incredible brand, incredible water, incredible purpose, incredible intentions. And yeah, so here we are a lot of years later.
Nicholas, you're now on the TSX. You're headed into a market which is super saturated. How do you plan on standing out in this beverage sector?
Yeah, very, very simple. My family's artesian spring in South Bruce County in Ontario releases a high quality still mineral water with functional benefits like alkalinity and electrolytes with an amazing smooth taste. The quality of our water puts us at the top end of the scale of the mineral water, and it's all naturally occurring, and we currently have a twin spring in Virginia that releases almost identical water. So the quality of our water puts us at the top against international competitors like Fiji, Avion, and the likes of. And so with that, that's the category of premium enhanced water. What I decided to do differently, and why Shawn and I met and partnered as the sustainability ambassador for the company and a shareholder, was we decided to do it in a plant-based renewable packaging that you see here, which is our 1 liter. This is all made from paperboard, mainly 75%, and even the cap's made from sugarcane. So we decided not to put it in a plastic bottle or glass or an aluminum can, and we decided to be the pioneers of a new category made from plant-based renewable resources that are 75% renewable as well as 100% recyclable.
Shawn, so let's pick up and expand on some of the things that Nicholas had just touched on with respect to ESG. So many companies focusing on ESG now. Tell me a little bit about their efforts. I mean, you had said right off the top of this conversation that your father went to take a look at where the water was sourced. What is it about their efforts that are, I guess, kind of, you know, attractive to you?
I mean, it's so authentic. It truly is like Nick truly with his heart believes in sustainability. And I think there's only one way that we're going forward, and that's taking care of the planet. Otherwise, we're not going forward. The only way I was going to work with a brand was if I met the team and felt that they were truly in it for the right reasons. And I mean, I think it was also, we're just addicted to the water, like my whole family and my friends. And unfortunately now I'm like texting Nick every other day being like, can I get a couple boxes sent to this friend and this friend? Yeah, it just really felt easy and nothing was forced, and everything felt very just like, I keep saying authentic, but that's where I go back to. And today's day and age, I feel like people can just kind of sniff through the fakeness and they can sense when things don't feel true. And that's not the case with Flo. So I truly am really, really proud to be a part of this family.
Nicholas, we know that Nestle sold Pure Life Brands last year. There has been a backlash when it comes to packaged water and sourcing water. How do you plan on navigating that?
Yeah. There definitely a lot of backlash for single use plastic in packaged water. That's why we decided to do something totally different. And of course, we have sustainability from day one, as Shawn was mentioning. It's super important for our company. We have goals. We just appointed a new CEO, Maurizio, who came from running Nestle as the global CEO and executive chair for many years. And he and I and Art Sean and the rest of our board members are definitely committed to the goals that we have to make the planet a better place. And we're progressing that every single day as we package every single product out of Toronto and Virginia.
I want to get into this. I want to ask Sean, because you mentioned right off the top that there are flavored waters now. Sean, do you have a preference?
The cucumber. I'm completely obsessed. But the truth is that I've always been a little bit skeptical of the flavored water taste, because I've always been like, this doesn't taste real. And I was kind of blown away when they first sent me the few beginning flavors, because how real they taste. It literally tastes like you cut up some cucumber and put it in the water, which is honestly a huge difference. If you're a flavored water lover, I think you're going to love it truly.
Tell us about your diversification plans. I mean, you had touched on the flavored water. You talk about the plants in Virginia and Toronto. You know, tell us about sourcing the water, about expansion.
Yeah. So we believe in the triple bottom line, which is people, profit, and the planet. So every decision that we make as a company falls within those three. And adding shareholder value is super important, especially when we're a public company, but not at the cost of the people and the communities around us and the planet at large. So when we look to expand our company, we'll look to further expand our spring capacity, our production capacity, in strategic areas that allow us to deliver it at a lower carbon footprint and lower cost of goods sold. So you can, and people are realizing that companies can make profit and do the responsible thing by taking into account the social and environmental impact of your products through your entire supply chain. So Flow will continue to acquire springs, will continue to build out capacity as we move to being a national success and a dominant player in the premium enhanced water category, both in Canada and the United States, where a lot of our growth is coming from.
We are talking about the beverage business, but Sean, we would be remiss if we didn't ask you about the music business. There seemed to be a formula. You put out your music, you put out an album, you went on tour, you performed at a concert. How has the pandemic changed the music business?
Absolutely. I think for any musician who has completely fallen in love with performing live, like I have, the last couple of years has been tough. But it's waking up, like all over the world, things are opening up and shows are happening, little shows. And this, it's gonna just like, I think people are gonna come back to concerts, including the musicians are gonna be on that stage being like, oh yeah, this is truly the most amazing gig in the world. And it's starting, you can feel it. The energy is right in the air all around us. So I think in the next few months, big shows will be starting back up.
Nicholas, with respect to what's on the horizon, what trends do you see in the beverage industry?
We see three mega trends that fall within the bullseye of Flow. You know, health and wellness is huge, better for you, nutrition, and hydration is a mega trend. We call that functional enhanced water that add functionality, and ours is around hydration functionality and nutrition with our collagen line, which is great. And so that's one mega trend. We're definitely seeing sustainability in the packaging driving consumer intent to purchase. Our category in sustainable water is growing double what the regular category is. And so that's another mega trend. And then the premiumization of products that add quality and value at the same time. So we see a lot of premium products like Flow. It's not a value product.
Exactly. I think you're tapping onto the fact that like most people in the world now are focused on, and hopefully will just get stronger and stronger on taking care of themselves and taking care of the planet. And I think that truly is probably the biggest cultural trend that's happening at the moment.